Coming back to the October 26th date and the printing of ballot papers for the fresh presidential election scheduled for October 26th starts this weekend. The Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission says the Dubai-based Al Ghurair company will print the ballot papers after all political parties rejected an offer presented by the UNDP. President Uhuru Kenyatta today signed into law the Supplementary Appropriation Bill 2017 that allocates 12 billion shillings for the October 26th poll.
With 11 days remaining to the repeat presidential election, IEBC says it's ready to conduct the poll and that all the 8 candidates who participated in the August 8th Bangor election will be included in the ballot. But Third Way Alliance leader Dr. Ekuru Aukot, after meeting with IEBC chairman Wafula Chebukati, said only his, Raila's and Uhuru Kenyatta's names should be included in the list of those participating in the poll. On Tuesday, NASA leader Raila Odinga withdrew from the race, insisting that he can only do so after IEBC is reformed. However, IEBC says NASA has not signed the official Form 24A confirming the decision. Al Ghurair will print the ballot papers despite strong opposition from NASA.
We don't have the time. If we choose that we are going to use another company, then we might as well accept that we are not going to be able to have an election on 26th of October. We reached out to the United Nations Development Fund program, UNDP. They offered to print ballot papers. Both parties said no. So when you are left as a commission, you are presenting such options. Both political parties tell you, no, we are not a banana republic. We will not have UNDP procure from another company. You just have to go with Al Ghurair or not print ballot papers.
Akombe says the electoral agency has resolved to standardize all Form 34As and Form 34Bs to avoid discrepancies highlighted by the Supreme Court. Akombe told election observers that the commission will not be rushed to announce results before verification and will utilize the 7 days provided for in the law to verify results before announcing the final tally. The commission has also reconfigured the KIMS gadgets to transmit both text and images simultaneously with a clearly defined complementary mechanism to prevent delays.
We really have been putting a very strong emphasis on ensuring that political parties, candidates, have agents in each of the polling stations. But in addition to that, what we are doing differently now is that we will have agents, ICT agents, embedded within our team.
The Center for Multi-Party Democracy met political party leaders and representatives from the civil society organizations and called on NASA and Jubilee leadership to drop grandstanding and chest thumping and embrace dialogue in resolving contentious issues ahead of the poll.
The politicians need to speak to each other, not at each other. That Kenya is one, in as much as we pretend to want to secede or perhaps break it.
This country needs an election. Good people, the IEBC must be held accountable to have the most credible of elections. We must ensure that the irreducible minimums that are reasonable are met. The ones that are not possible, we'll file them for another time. The election law, those are reasonable, I think can be applied. Those are unfair, should be suspended for the next election.
For purposes of this coming election, let IEBC open up. Let all parties see what it is doing. And let the IEBC insulate itself from political maneuvers.
All constituency returning officers will be required to project real-time entry of results into the results transmission kits and give a draft of the form to all agents and media before printing an original to be signed by the poll official and the agents.
We have told our returning officers that they will need to give unfettered access to the media. They will need to also provide a draft form 34B and the final, so that they can be able, the media can be able to cover what is going on at the constituency level.
IEBC has dropped over 200 presiding officers and some returning officers who made errors in the nullified election. Safaricom will be the commission's main service provider and will provide the 3G network for results transmission. However, Airtel Kenya and Telkom will still be involved. IEBC says the number of polling stations without the 3G network has reduced from 11,000 to nearly 3,000 stations.
Safaricom, I mean, let's be honest with each other. Safaricom is the main provider in this country. It is the main provider. Yes, there are other providers. It is the main provider. So to say that we cannot use Safaricom to transmit results, we will be lying to you.
Meanwhile, at Status Nairobi, President Uhuru Kenyatta received the controversial electoral laws amendment bills that were rushed and unanimously passed by Jubilee lawmakers. Uhuru has 14 days to sign the two draft bills into law. Patrick Amimo, KTN News.